Hey everybody, it is Sunday night. Today was the end of the 7-day challenge for me, and I am proud to say, I'm very relieved to say as well, that I have finished this challenge. I painted all 38 US infantry in 7 days. Wow, not a struggle. It wasn't a struggle, overall. It was okay. I wouldn't do it again. It's just a lot of the same thing. 38 of the same guys in 28mm, it's a lot. I'm happy I'm done. I'm happy I got these guys done. It was a nice way to kind of force myself to get all these guys done, which probably wouldn't have happened as, very soon if I didn't do this. So thank you for all those people who commented and supported and encouraged me to get in gear. Of course, Tristan for that initial comment that got this going, and whether he was joking or not, look what happened. So thank you. Let me just do a quick little look through, and I'll explain what I've got, and I'll talk about how it went. So here, I won't get too close, but you can see the lieutenant in the middle with the man. That's one of his extra dudes. He can get another one, of course. He can, any rifleman can stand in as well. I didn't put a line on his helmet yet. I just thought of that like today when I was finishing up the bases. So I'll add that to him. On the left, you can see the bazooka team. And unlike my airborne bazooka team, these guys are individually based. I would have liked the consistency, but I didn't have the proper kind of base for these guys. So two it is. On the right, you can see a sniper and his extra man for the little sniper team. I thought it was pretty obligatory to have a sniper just in case I needed to put one into my list. Yeah, generic dude. Over here, six NCOs with submachine guns. So that means I can have six squads built up at the same time. Here are six BAR gunners. I can have six together. Not six together, but six different squads, each with an NCO and a BAR plus some riflemen, and I've got 32 riflemen. So I'm not going to do the mental math right now because I'm tired. After a night of going to bed at 4:30 and then another one going to bed at 1:30, so I'm not making up for the lack of sleep. I am tired, so I'm going to go to bed in a little while. But I want to have this video up, and because I'm just totally happy that it's done. So the 32 riflemen with a variety of poses, and no one is a copy of another. They're all unique in some way. There's six different poses, so and I think it was like 8 or 10 different heads, so I tried to mix and match as much as I could, and I think it went pretty well. So nice variety. So so I can have, I can have like, two squads, three squads, I guess up to three. I can get up to three full squads, or up to six, like half squads, like 6-man squads, or 3 12-man squads plus the teams in the front. So that's pretty cool. That's a nice variety there. And, whenever I start playing the game, that's going to be good. So I can really scale up or scale down and try out different things, multiple small units or nice big large units. I have to play the game and I'll test that out. But anyway, really happy the way they turned out. I did, on a couple guys here and there, I skipped like a step, or I didn't add a detail that I could have or would have normally, just for expediency's sake. But it's things like the belt buckle that you can't really see on most of the guys. Definitely not from this angle. You can see them from up close. So the ones that like details like that I definitely showed, but there are a lot of details, not a lot, but a bunch of details that I decided to just to skip out, just to help me get through this faster. But there are things that you won't be able to tell from the tabletop, from top down during a battle. So 13 of them have backpacks, so I can have like a 12-man squad, and two of the BAR gunners have backpacks. So if I do have a 12-man squad in backpacks, it could be one of the late war lists that allow for two BARs, or it can just be a regular one. So, you know, I have 13 guys, so I can either be one way or the other, one BAR or two BARs. The rifles are mostly M1 Garands, but of course we all know that the box and the kits don't have enough rifles to outfit everyone. So there are a bunch of carbines in there as well. At first I didn't like the idea, but the you know rules wise they have the same kind of special rules, so it all works out. As you can see, they're on my new mat that I got at IKEA. It's 2x3, which is way more than I need. I will be cutting it up to make fields for both 28 mil and 15 mil, as a little hint and a idea of what might be coming up in the future. But I don't need it all, so I'm going to be sharing it and sharing the price and or splitting the cost with a local or two, and it just gives all of us some more terrain. This is the first time I've found one in like all of Toronto and everywhere that I've looked that doesn't have a message on it, like a big welcome lettering or like a design or something. So very cool that I finally found that, and not a bad price, I guess, overall for as much as you get. So anyway, thank you to everyone for watching all these videos and for all the comments on YouTube and G Plus, and definitely nice encouragement. Yeah, it was definitely helpful this last week. Congratulations to everyone who joined in. Dervin finished his after a really rough week, which is craziness. Glad everything turned out all right with him, and good to see that he knows how to paint the rest of those soldiers, and yeah, he can go on with it now and paint more. Tristan finished his early. He admits, you know, he had less guys, but the first shot I saw, they looked really good, so I can't wait to see a nice video recap with all of them all done, and I think they're gonna look really cool, as his stuff usually does. Pinky finished his already, so that was cool. You can check that out, and it's more of these guys, and again, it was almost hard to follow up the high quality that he did, because mine is such a much simpler painting technique. But you know what? Looking at them on the table here, I'm totally happy with my. Like, they look to me, they look great at you know tabletop height. So it's fantastic. I'm really happy. British Legion. I'm hoping to see what he's got. Sorry if I forgot anyone else that had done it, but anyway, if anyone else wants to do their own 7-day challenge, just do it. Just post a video, share it, and challenge yourself to do. You know, could be 4 models, could be 38 models, could be a giant one, could be a squad, could be a variety, whatever you want to challenge yourself with. This definitely helped me get these guys done. Like I said, you know, it wouldn't have happened otherwise. So. That was really the challenge. Painting 38, 28 mil guys in 1 week, that is a challenge for sure. I'm glad I did it. I don't think I'll be doing it again, but it did force me to get these guys done, so now I can use them. And it's one more project that I can be done with. So anyway, thanks again. Thanks for watching, thanks for the encouragement, and yeah, next time you see these guys, hopefully they'll be on the battlefield. And next video you'll see will hopefully be whatever my next project is. Don't have much time before Spookytoberfest. I still want to do a cancer awareness build, but I'll see what I can do in the next week before Spookytoberfest begins. And I already know what I'm going to do for that. So that intro video will be coming soon. Anyway, thank you again, and have a good one. Bye.